something happening here. What it is ain't exactly clear. There's a man with a gun over there telling me I got to beware. It's time to stop, children, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going down.
Has come for America to hear the truth about this tragic war, that I see this war as an unjust, evil, and futile war.
We cannot, as a free nation, compete with our adversaries in tactics of terror, assassination, false promises, counterfeit mobs, and crises.
Today, our fellow citizens, our way of life, our very freedom came under attack in a series of deliberate and deadly terrorist acts. Thousands of lives were suddenly ended by evil, despicable acts of terror. The pictures of airplanes flying into buildings, fires burning, huge structures collapsing, have filled us with disbelief, terrible sadness, and a quiet, unyielding anger.
Moreover, when the issues at hand seem as perplexing as they often do in the case of this dreadful conflict, we are always on the verge of being mesmerized by uncertainty.
Intelligence gathered by this and other governments leaves no doubt that the Iraqi regime continues to possess and conceal some of the most lethal weapons ever devised. This regime has already used weapons of mass destruction against Iraq's neighbors and against Iraq's people.
Rationalizations and the incessant search for scapegoats are the psychological cataracts that blind us to our sin.
Saddam Hussein and his sons must leave Iraq within 48 hours. Their refusal to do so will result in military conflict commenced at a time of our choosing.
How many wars, Winston Churchill has written, have been averted by patience and persisting goodwill? How many wars have been precipitated by firebrands?
You've got grenades going off, you've got an IED blowing up your vehicle. And then you're expected to go back in those 4 to 5 hours and get and relax, to come back out and do another 6 hours. You don't have time. You just don't have time to do it. Your body never gets to come down.
Fear of Saddam has been replaced by fear of an even less identifiable terror. Every car with no passengers could be a suicide bomber. Fear that your neighbor might be a spy for Saddam's secret police has been replaced by fear that the police may actually be death squads loyal to a different brand of Islam.
I had a healthy fear of and respect for Viet Cong booby traps, hair-thin lines that would be pulled across a jungle path called a bouncing Betty, which was, in effect, a grenade that would just blow up an ankle level.
Saddam Hussein has placed Iraqi troops and equipment in civilian areas, attempting to use innocent men, women, and children as shields for his own military.
The security of the world requires disarming Saddam Hussein now.
And while we believe not only in the force of arms, but in the force of right and reason, we have learned that reason does not always appeal to unreasonable men.
Do you think it's a mistake to explain about Vietnam and what we're faced with?
Well, I do think, Mr. President, that it'd be wise for you to say as little as possible. The frank answer is we don't know what's going on out there. Signs I see coming through the cables are disturbing signs. It's a very uncertain period.
We cannot, under the scrutiny of a free press and public, tell different stories to different audiences, foreign and domestic.
It began with shock and awe. that quickly led to the fall of Saddam Hussein and these now infamous words from President Bush.
In the Battle of Iraq, the United States and our allies have prevailed.
Major combat may have ended. However, the war is far from over. Even with Iraq's dictator captured and executed and a new democratic government in place, U.S. troops have not been able to contain the insurgency and sectarian violence.
We send arms to other peoples, just as we send them the ideals of democracy in which we believe. But we cannot send them the will to use those arms or to abide by those ideals.
For in all our history, there has never been such a monumental descent during a war by the American people, of a society gone mad on war, like some demonic, destructive suction tube.
A huge explosion damaged the golden dome of one of Iraq's most famous Shiite shrines this morning in the town of Samarra, north of Baghdad. The attack caused widespread outrage.
Americans suffered their heaviest casualties of the war in Vietnam last week, 543 killed in action. Another 1,247 were wounded and hospitalized. The deaths raised the U.S. toll in the war so far to 18,239.
There are those who are seeking to equate dissent with disloyalty. It's a dark day in our nation when high-level authorities will seek to use every method to silence dissent.
We are poor and tired people, Taha, the bookseller says. For 3 years now, no services, no water, no electricity. What, he asks, have they done to us?
For the first time since the ancient battles between Greek city-states, war entails the threat of total annihilation of everything we know of society itself.
My fellow citizens, at this hour, American and coalition forces are in the early stages of military operations to disarm Iraq, to free its people, and to defend the world from grave danger. These are opening stages of what will be a broad and concerted campaign. More than 35 countries are giving crucial support.
What makes us omniscient? Have we a record of omniscience? We are the strongest nation in the world today. I do not believe we should ever apply that economic, political, or military power unilaterally. If we had followed that rule in Vietnam, we wouldn't have been there. None of our allies supported us, not Japan, not Germany, not Britain or France. If we can't persuade nations with comparable values of the merit of our cause, we'd better re-examine our reasoning.
And we must face the fact that the United States is neither omnipotent nor omniscient, that we are only 6% of the world's population, and that we cannot impose our will upon the other 94% of mankind, that we cannot right every wrong or reverse each adversity, and that therefore there cannot be an American solution to every world problem.
Imagine there's no heaven. See if you try.